Long hair has a lot of drawbacks.
Mm-hmm.
And then they always just like one stray hair and it'll get stuck to your arm and you're like, I can't find it. It's like itchy.
Let's take one, Mark.
How's it going, Firebase developers? Welcome to another episode of Ask Firebase, the show where we answer your burning Firebase questions. I'm your host, Jen Person, and for my co-host today, I am welcoming back Abe Haskins.
Hi, thanks.
You're welcome. Thanks for coming on. Are you ready to educate me, babe?
I am so ready.
The first question comes from Yo-Yo Yusei, who says, does exporting multiple cloud functions in one index.js file affect a boot time of functions?
Yeah, this is a great question. We get asked this all the time, and it's hard to give an answer about. And the reason that is because I talk to a lot of developers, you talk to a lot of developers, a lot of them do really crazy things. They do absolutely ridiculous things, and they do end up impacting things like this. In theory, the answer should be no. When you're coming from a cold start in Cloud Functions, it does have to reevaluate all your JavaScript. So in theory, if your application was hundreds of thousands of lines, when it does that initial evaluation, you could see some noticeable lag to the user. Like, in theory, you could. It is very unlikely, though. However, I am not inclined to say you won't see this because I've seen ridiculous things that people do, and they do get into situations where, for example, they're parsing something like templates way in advance, so they have hundreds of templates, and they parse those and then do something in their JavaScript, and until then, it's blocking. And so they can't actually, you know, run that JavaScript until this other unrelated operation is done. Or they're connecting to a database or something external every time the function gets ready to be ran. So in those cases, it definitely can. I don't think the size of that JavaScript file is going to really impact it. But other things you're doing in that boot, that initial start, connections to external things, those definitely can. And in theory, if you had a huge, huge application, it could, just by the size of the JavaScript, make a few second difference. But it is quite unlikely that you'll get to that.
So it's less about the number of cloud functions and more about what you're doing.
Yeah,
at the beginning
yeah.
Of that.
And it's the same thing as like building any other application. The slow things are like network I/O, waiting on external services. Those things will slow you down much more than the speed of evaluating JavaScript will.
Great question. You ready for another?
Yep.
All right. So the next question comes from Carlos Subs, who wants to know, what's the correct way to split index.ts into a number of different files? Looks like everyone has a different hack to make such a trivial thing.
Yep. And so this is a great follow-up from that last question, because in theory, the technical performance of a big JavaScript app doesn't make that much difference in terms of evaluating it or running it. However, logically, in terms of maintenance and building things that you can actually keep working on for a number of years, this type of stuff really matters. So here he's talking about, how do we split up an index.ts file? What can we do to, you know, make that more manageable? Not so much from a technical side, but from the just like, I'm editing this. I want this to be sane and reasonable. And sadly, unlike the last question, which kind of had an answer, this one does not have an answer. If you've been in the JavaScript ecosystem for very long, you probably know that we only kind of recently agreed on the technical implementation of modules, yet alone how to use them or what good patterns are. Like, you will get a million views about how to do this. So sadly, there isn't really an answer here. But I can give you some general advice about TypeScript, which is that it is cheap to split things into multiple files. It's pretty rare that you'll find much of any disadvantage between splitting things up more. It doesn't make any impact in Cloud Functions because it is always compiled into JavaScript, and it does its own optimizations in there. So even if you were trying to be really fancy about how your modules existed, if you end up rolling them up into a single JavaScript file, it's not going to make any difference. And depending on how your TypeScript is set up, you may or may not be doing that. And so it's just really, really hard to say.
So maybe the correct way to split it is the way that it's most intuitive to you as the developer, so
yeah,
that you can access the different information you need quickly?
Yep, I would think that's really it. It's just what feels right in your application. It doesn't matter that much. One really cool hack in TypeScript, which is a little bit of an aside, but it's really cool, is that if you have a main like index.ts file and you have a bunch of modules that are around, you know, maybe you have signup.ts and you have, you know, email.ts, whatever, anytime you call import something from one of those files, you can change that to export something from one of those files. And what that does is just immediately passes whatever you're importing out as an export. So like Cloud Functions, where you're required to export the function that you're setting up, you could put that in one of those files and have your index.ts just be like the thinnest shim that exports my function from another TS file. And that lets you keep everything separated out from that index, right? So the only thing that index actually does is pull everything together for that final bit. But all of your actual functions, your code, is all separated out into nice different files.
I love that idea. You could have a different file for each of your Cloud Functions.
Yep, and just keep it nice and isolated and clean.
Beautiful. Well, thank you.
Yeah. Yo, I had a question for you. I heard we did some announcements about MLKit for Firebase, but I haven't really been able to keep up on that. Are you working on anything related to that?
Yeah. So I've been playing with the great code lab that we have put together. We actually gave it the Firebase Summit as well, checking out the new features of MLKit. And then we have an example on iOS and Android, which enables you to check out our face contour, which is one of our latest APIs, so you can find the different points on the face. It's great for adding filters, and it also has text recognition in it and landmark recognition, so it's really cool.
Facial landmark?
Facial
landmark. Like there is the Eiffel Tower.
Well, yes, actually, that is one of the things. The landmark is the term that you use for like describing the nose and the mouth. These are considered landmarks of the face.
That's not a joke then. Never mind.
I definitely thought about like Eiffel Tower the first time I read that. I feel like that's the example we always use for like landmark.
It's detection. The only landmark anyone cares about.
It's like the easiest one to detect too. Yeah. I want something that's like really hard to detect. Show me like one rock and like tell me.
That's that important rock from Nevada. You know the one.
That's Jimmy the Rock.
Just Jimmy the Rock.
Thank you so much for coming on and answering these great questions.
Yeah, thanks for having me. I'm so glad people keep asking great questions. Every time I come back, the questions are better than last time.
Yeah, and that's why your questions are so important, because the questions that we get through Ask Firebase really do lead us to come play with the code and discover new things, and it helps us make cool demos and solve problems. So make sure that if you have queries for us, you're tagging them on social media with the hashtag AskFirebase. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you on a future episode. Bye-bye. I'm so excited to hear what you have to teach me.
Yeah, that's great. I'm glad you learn stuff when you have new co-hosts, because I've been here several times. You got nothing to learn from me.
I have nothing to learn.